Subbu from bloggingattraction.com. Normally, if you see any WordPress theme, they come with some default widget areas like the sidebar widget areas, the footer widget areas, and you can add any widgets into those widget areas like text widgets, calendar widgets, etc. But if you want to show some widget at some place where you don't have any widget area, how can you do that? For doing that, first you have to add some new widget area into that place, and then you can add those new widgets into that particular widget area. So in this video, I would like to show you how you can add a new widget area into any WordPress theme. This is not about adding a new widget, but this is about adding a new widget area into any WordPress theme. So watch this video.
So this one, I'm showing it to you on my blog, bloggingmypassion.com. And the theme I am using for this blog is FashionPress. So this is the theme I am using. So FashionPress theme comes up with a header and two column layouts. The first column contains all the posts that I have made, and the second column contains all the widgets. So the different widgets, you can see it here, the full width widget, right widget, and footer widget. And also we have also left widget we have. So if you see it here, so these are the default widgets that are coming with the WordPress FashionPress theme. So this is the full width widget. So here you can see that I have added recent posts and also categories. And we also have a left widget where I have added pages and recent comments, and we also have a right widget. Right now I haven't added anything here. So these are the default widgets that are coming with this FashionPress theme. What I would like to do is, I would like to add a new widget at this place. That means above these posts, I would like to add a new widget, because I would like to show some featured posts as an image slideshow. I would like to show my featured posts as an image slideshow. I would like to put an image slideshow at this point. So right now, for this theme, we don't have any widget at this point. So I would like to add that new widget, and I would like to show you how to add that new widget. Moreover, I would like to add the new widget only on the home page. I don't want to add it on any posts page or any other pages like contact us or privacy policy on these pages. I would like to add that only on the home page, because I would like to show the image slideshow only on the home page. So I will show you how to do this one. And before adding any new widget area, the first thing we have to do is, we have to register that widget. There are two things we have to do. First thing is, we have to register the widget, and the second thing is, we have to add some PHP code to the home page of this theme to show that particular widget wherever we want. So these are the two things we have to do. The first thing is registering the widget. Let's see how we can register the widget. For registering the widget, actually we have to edit a PHP file called functions.php. So that's where all the widgets are registered. And for editing that functions.php file, you don't need to really go into your hosting account and edit the files there. You can directly do it under appearance section in your admin area. Just click on the editor link. So once you click on this, it will show you all the files that can be edited. If you see here, so these are all the templates that are available and that can be edited. So if you see, the first thing we have to edit is functions.php file. So just edit this one, click on this, and it will show it here. Okay, so if you see this one, see, these are all the different widgets that are already there. Full width widget, left widget, right widget, and footer widget. So if you see here, see, these are the default widgets: full width widget, left widget, right widget, and footer widget. So for registering a widget, it is very simple. What you can do is just copy any of this one and paste it and change the name of that widget. So this is what we have to do. Just copy this one. I have copied the first one and I am pasting it here. Okay, I have copied and pasted it here, and I'm just changing the name of this widget here as home page top widget. Save this one, update file. Okay, file edited successfully. That means it is saved successfully. So now let's go to the admin area under appearance section, under widgets section. Just refresh this one and see if your new widget is coming up here. Whenever you register any new widget, that has to come under the widgets area. So if you see it here, see, this is the home page top widget. This is the new one that we have added. So this one, it came here. Now, in order to show the new widget at this point, and since we want to show it only on the home page, you have to edit this home page template. Normally, in any WordPress theme, the home page is index.php file. So let's go to our editor and see if there is any index.php. See, here is the index.php file. Edit this one. Okay, so now it is edited. If you see this one, see, just observe the PHP script here. If you see, the first line is PHP get underscore header. That means what it will do is, it will get the header. See, all this logo and this pages information, all this one, it comes by this get underscore header function. The next one is id is equal to div, id is equal to column 1. So this is what we want, because in this column 1 we would like to add our widget. So under this one, just we need to add little code. So I'm just adding this one. What we have to open a php tag, and I'm just putting a comment here, just to, you know, in case next time if I come back and see, I can easily understand that I have added a new code here. So home page top widget start, that means this is where the new widget is starting. Now put an if condition. If not, function underscore exists of dynamic underscore sidebar are not dynamic underscore sidebar of, here we have to give the new widget name that we have created. It is home page top widget. So now close the if function. Now this is done. Close the PHP tag here. Okay, we have created a if functionality here. We are checking if dynamic sidebar is existing, or if dynamic underscore sidebar functionality function is existing. If nothing is existing, then we have to end this if tag. Again, open a PHP tag, and if, that means we are ending this if tag that we have created. I'm just putting another comment here, which is home page top widget end. Close the PHP tag. Save this one. Update file. Okay, file edited successfully. That means it is saved. Now let us go to our home page and refresh this one. It's not showing anything here right now. This is because we have created the widget area, but we haven't really added into that widget anything. That's why it's not showing up anything here. So let's go to our homepage widget and just add some text for testing purpose. So let's see where is okay, this is text widget, arbitrary text or HTML. So let's go to our home page top widget and put it there. So here I'm saying featured posts. Hi, this is the new widget created. Save it. Minimize this one. Go to our home page and check this one. Okay, so now the widget is created and it's good, but see, like, you know, you need to have some kind of a CSS knowledge here, cascading style sheets knowledge, you know, so that, like, you know, you can style this one as you want. So what I would like to do is, like, you know, I would like to have the same border like this that I have here to this widget also. So what I can do is I can again go to this editor and see, this is the one, the div id is equal to content box. So this is the one actually creating the particular box. So div id is equal to content box, I'm putting it there and I'm closing the div tag here, close div and save it. Okay, file edited successfully, that means it is saved. Let's go to our home page and refresh this one. Okay, see, now it looks much better than the earlier one. Now I have created a border around this widget. So if you have a CSS knowledge, you know, cascading style sheets knowledge, you can do it, like, you know, easily, and you can style it as you know, as you like. Okay, now what I would like to do is, like, you know, I would like to put a slideshow, image slideshow of my featured posts here. I have already created that image slideshow, and okay, so this is the one. Let's put it here and see how it is working. Okay, and I'm just taking out this text one. Okay, so shape file, image and content fader. So this one I have already created, the this one, so I'm just putting it here and I'll show it to you, like, you know, how to create an image slideshow using the different WordPress plugins in a different tutorial. But since this tutorial is mainly for adding a new widget area, I have already created this one and placed it somewhere, and now I just added that one here. Now let's go to our home page and refresh this one and see how it is working. Okay, so this is the image slideshow. See, it is here, it is showing the left arrow and also right arrow, and if you click this left arrow or right arrow, it will show the other posts and it will show the description of the posts also. And if you click on any of these things, it will go to that particular particular post. And as you can see, you know, I have added this widget only on the home page. That's why you can't see it on any of the other actual post sections. So if you see this post, you are not seeing that particular widget here. Or if you see, if you check any page, any other page, you know, other than home page, there also you won't see this one. You can see it only on the home page because I have added that widget area only on the home page. If you would like to add it to any other pages or post section, see, single.php is the one that is responsible for posts category. I mean, whatever the individual posts, like, you know, this file is responsible. So if you would like to have that new widget on each and every post, then you have to edit this one and, you know, use the same code that we have used here, and page.php is the one that is responsible for all these pages, like, you know, the different pages like contact us, privacy policy, etc. So if you would like to have the same kind of widget on these pages also, you have to edit this page.php. so This is the tutorial for adding a new widget area to any WordPress theme. So let's go ahead and let me recap this one again. There are two things you have to do for adding a new widget area to any WordPress theme. The first thing is you have to register the widget, new widget, and the second one is you have to modify the template of the page, home page, or whatever page that you want to show the new widget, and put some new code there to show the new widget area. So if you go to the for registering the new widget, you have to edit this functions.php file, and this functions.php file is the one where all the widgets are registered. You can see it here, the widgets are registered here: full widget, left widget, right widget, and footer widget. In a similar way, we have to register our new widget also. The new widget is home page top widget. So doing this is very simple. Just copy any of this one, paste it here, and change the name of that widget. So here I have copied the first one and changed the name of the widget. And once you do this one, then you can, and once you do this and save it, then you can see the new widget name under the widgets section under appearance in the admin area. So you can see it here, like, you know, the new widget that we have created, the home page top widget, we can see it here once we register that new widget in functions.php file. So once the widget is registered and once the widget is showing up here, then what you have to do is, for showing up the new widget area on any page you want, you have to edit the corresponding template, the corresponding theme template. So if you see this one, since I would like to show it only on the home page, in any theme, in any WordPress theme, the template responsible for showing the home page is index.php. So I have edited this one and I have added some small amount of code there in a particular place. Again, you need to understand this file, you know, so that you can clearly, you will be able to place the widget, you know, at whatever point you need. So in this one, since I need it above the post, I have added it under the column 1 section, and I have, you need to also know little CSS knowledge to style the new widget area that you have added. In this case, since I just wanted to have a border like this, you know, the same way these posts are having here, yeah, I just copied one of the existing CSS tag and put it here. That's why, like, you know, I'm able to show a border here. So if you have a little CSS knowledge, you can do it very easily. And since I would like to have the new widget area only on the home page, I have just edited this index.php file. And if you would like to have it, like, you know, on any other pages or on the post page, you can edit this page.php or single.php files and place the same code there. And the code that we have placed here is if not function underscore exists dynamic underscore sidebar or not dynamic underscore sidebar of homepage top widget, then end if. So this is very small one, and you can just pause this video and copy it down. So this is the code that we have to add. Hope this tutorial is helpful to you. Thank you.
Okay guys, now you know how you can add new widget areas into any WordPress theme. So just go ahead and try adding some new widget areas and adding some new widgets into those newly added widget areas. If you are new to this YouTube channel and if you want to see my channel, just go ahead and click that channel link here and you will be able to see my channel. If you would like to see all the videos I have created, just click on the videos link here and you will be able to see all the videos I have created. If you would like to see my blog, which is bloggingmypassion.com, just click on the blog link here and you will be able to go to my blog and you can check all the posts over there. Also, please leave your comments in the comment box below. If you don't understand something about something in this video, or if you have any questions, so that I'll be able to answer those questions. Finally, if you like this video, please click on the subscribe link here and subscribe to my channel, which is Blogging My Passion. Thank you very much.